Hi friends, this is Subrat here, and in this video I'm going to explain about how we can work with text data. So let's start. So we'll see with different examples how we can work with text data. So before that, I need to import my required libraries. Here I need pandas and numpy libraries, that's why I have imported these two libraries. So here we'll see how we can work with text data. That means if inside a data structure you have text variables are present or categorical variables are present, then what are some operations you can perform on them? So here at first I am creating a series containing the text data. So here you can see everything inside my series is a text format. Then let's see what are some basic operations that you can perform on this text data. So at first I will convert all these elements into lowercase letters. My series contains the mix of upper and lowercase character variables, but if I want to convert all these elements into lowercase letter, then I can use the syntax like this. So here one thing you need to keep in mind, all this string operation you have to perform upon my string class, which is str. So whatever the inbuilt methods are there for string variables, you have to call the str class and then you have to call that method. So here str.lower I have to call to convert all these elements into the lowercase characters. So here you can see ser is my object, which is series type, and upon this object I am calling the str string class, and inside that string class only I have the lower method present. That's why I can able to convert all these characters into lowercase letter. So here you can see output ABC, all are converted into lowercase characters. So similarly, you can also convert all these characters into uppercase character from lower to uppercase. So you have to call in same format. So str is my string class, upon string class only you have to call the upper method. So here ser.str.upper method, if you are calling like this, every individual variables inside the str object will be converted into uppercase characters. So let's see how we can get the length of each elements. So length here means how many number of characters are there inside individual elements. So here I have only one character, here one, so here I have four character, here I have four character, here I have 4, 3, 3. So if you want to get the length of individual elements, then you can use the length method. So you have to call the length method upon my string class only, ser.str.length method. So you will get the individual length of individual elements. So let's see, we have seen here how we can perform some basic operations on my series object. So let's create one index object and let's do some basic operations on it. So here you can see by using the pandas.index method, you can create an index variable. So here index signifies the column names of your data frame. So the string method on index are especially useful for cleaning up or transforming data frame columns. For instance, you may have columns with leading or trailing white spaces. Suppose in your data frame columns you have leading or trailing white spaces like this. Here you can see before Jack you have a leading white space and after Jill you have a trailing white space. So if white spaces are there inside your column names, then it will be difficult for us to refer that column. You have to count how many number of white spaces are there, then only you can refer to that column. So it is better to remove all these white spaces before and after the column names. So in that case you can use the strip method to do that operation. So you have to call the strip method upon my string class only. So idx is my index object, and upon my index object I am calling the str class, and inside that str class I have the strip method present. So if you call like this idx.str.strip, then the trailing and leading white spaces will be removed from your column names. So this is the most useful function inside the pandas library, that you can use to remove the trailing and leading white spaces from your column names. So you can also remove only the left white space, or you can also remove the right white space. So you have to call lstrip. Lstrip will remove only the left white spaces present inside the column names. Here you can see in front of Jack I have left white space, in front of Jesse I have left white space. That's why if you have called lstrip, then it has removed the left white spaces from your column names. You can use the rstrip to remove the right white spaces. Here you can see I have the right white space after the Jill. If you have used rstrip, then right white spaces will be removed from your column names. So let's see with one practical examples. Suppose I have a data frame called DF, and inside my data frames I have column names like person, year, income, age and sex, and I have leading and trailing white spaces inside my column names. So in that case, how we can remove those white spaces? So if you print df.columns, it will give you the list of columns available inside your data frame object. Here you can see we have lot of spaces around my column names. So it is not good programming practice to have spaces around your column names. You have to remove those spaces. So here you can see if you call df.columns.str.strip, then it will remove the white spaces from your column names. But again, if you have print df.columns, then the white spaces are still there. It has not updated to my original data frame DF. To do that, I have to write a code like this. Instead of doing it alone, after removing the white space, I have to assign it to my df.columns series. So here this statement will return a series type object, and that series only I am assigning to my df.columns series. So if you print again df.columns, you will see that white spaces are removed around my column names. So it will be changed to my original data frame DF here. So in this way, you can remove the white spaces around your column names by calling the strip method upon the string class. So if you want to remove some unwanted characters from your column names, then how we can do that? Suppose I have a space in between my column names. If you print your data frame, it will come like this with spaces. Suppose you want your column names with underscore like this. If you have space in between the column names, you want to place a underscore there, then you can use the inbuilt method called replace. So replace method will accept two arguments. The first argument is the old value that you want to replace, and the second argument is the new value that you want to replace with. So here you can see the old value is the white spaces. These white spaces I want to replace it with the underscore value. So you can call like this. This is called method chaining operation. So you are just calling both strip method and replace method in a single statement. So it will allow us to do this operation. You are just stripping the white spaces and you are just replacing the white spaces also. So here you can see you will get the output like this: person underscore name, then present underscore year, then person underscore income, then person underscore age, then person underscore sex. So in this way, you can replace the unwanted characters from your column names. So let us see some other operation that we can perform upon my column names. So splitting string columns. So here you can split the string column names also. If inside your series you have variables like this A underscore B underscore C, C, D, E, F, G, H. Here I want to split this column names on underscore. So if you have split it like this, you will get a list in this case, ABC. So ABC has been splitted and it has returned to a list. So CDE has been splitted and it has returned a list here, CDE. And here FGH has been splitted and it has returned FGH list. Don't split the column names here. Suppose I have column names like this: person space name, present space year, person space income, person space age, and person space x. And you want to split these column names upon my space variable here. So if you are trying to do that, it will give you an error, because after splitting, the split method is going to return me a list as a my column names, but you don't want a list as your column names. That's why it will give you an error here. So let us see some other operations that we can perform upon my string data. So let's do first series concatenation. Suppose I have a series like this, pd dot series abcd, and I just want to concatenate these elements abcd and to form a single string variable. So I can do like this. I can use the cat method. So cat method is shortcut for the concatenation operation. You can call the dot cat method. It will just concatenate individual elements present inside your series like this, and it will return you a single string variable abcd like this. And you can also use the separation scp argument to separate the individual elements with some value here. So I want to separate the individual elements with a comma, then the output will be like this: a comma b comma c comma d. In this way you can concatenate the individual elements present inside your series object. So by default, missing values are ignored. Using na underscore rep, they can be given a representation. So if you have missing values inside your series, by default it will be ignored. It will not added to your concatenation operation. But you can use the na underscore rep to give a special symbol to your missing values. So if you have concatenated like this cat and you have separated, then missing values, then this missing value will be ignored and it will give you output like this a b and d. And if you want to give some meaningful representation to your missing value, then you can use na underscore rep argument. It will give you a output like this a b hyphen d. So concatenating a series and something list like into a series. Suppose my original series is SCR. So under SCR I have a b and a nan value and a d. And if I want to concatenate this list with my original series object, so I can do like this. So these are the values I want to concatenate with my series object. So individual values from my series object will be concatenated with individual values of my list here. So a has been concatenated with capital A, b has been concatenated with capital B, and na has been concatenated with c, and the result is also nan, and d has been concatenated with capital D. So in this way you can do the concatenation operation. So let's see some other operation what we can perform on my string values. So you can use the indexing concept to get the individual characters from your string variables. So here I have a series like this, and I want to get the first character of my individual elements. So here the first character will be A, here the first character will be B, here the first character will be C, here the first character will be A, here the first character will be B, and here the second character will be small a, here the second character will be small a, so here the second character will be O. So if you want to get the characters, so if you want to get the character values, then you can use the indexing concept. Then you have to pass the index of your character and you will get those values. So if you are doing like this, scr.str of 0, that means you are asking for first character of individual elements only, then you will get the output like this. If you want the second characters of individual elements, then you will do like this, str of 1. That means you want the second characters of individual elements. If second character is not present, then it will give you the nn as an output. So testing for a string that matches or contains a pattern. So let's do here some string matching operation. Suppose I have a pattern like this, 0 to 9 and alphabets from A to Z. Suppose I want to match elements those contains numbers from 0 to 9 and the alphabets from A to Z here. Suppose this is my series object 1 2 3 a 3 b and 0 3 c, and I want to match this pattern and I want to check whether individual elements contains this pattern or not. In that case, I can use the contents method to do this operation. So here you can see, if you have used the contents method and inside that contents method you have passed the patterns that you want to check. So here you will get the boolean values as an output. So here you can check the first element contains only numbers, but my pattern should have a number and a character value, number from 0 to 9 and characters from small a to small z. But in case of first element I have only number, that's why my output is false here. In case of second element I have only number, that's why my output is false here. But in case of third element I have both numbers and characters, that's why the output is true here. In case of fourth I have both characters and numbers, that's why the output is true. In fifth case I have both numbers and characters, that's why the output is true here. So the contents method is checking whether my individual elements contains this pattern or not. So let me run this again. Suppose this is my pattern and let's put a character before it, small z. So here also you can see the output is true. That means it is checking whether my individual elements contains the pattern like this, numbers from 0 to 9 and characters from small a to small z, these variables containing these patterns, that's why the output is true here. So if you put a D in front of 2, let's see what's the output we are getting. So still we are getting false as an output, because my pattern should be the starting character should be a number and the second character should be a character type. But in this case my starting is a character and second is a number type, that's why it is giving me a false. Here we have some other method to do this operation. We can use the match method. So let's see what the output you are getting if you are using the match method. So same pattern you want to match with the individual elements over here. If you run this statement you will get the output like this. So here the first element is giving you false because you don't have this pattern inside your first element. Second element is giving false, third element is giving true, fourth element is giving true, and the fifth element is giving false. Let's see why my fifth element is giving false. Because I have numbers like this, because I have a number before and a character after, so it should give a true here. So the match method is strictly matching these values. That means your pattern should be first letter should be a number and second letter should be a character. But here the first letter is number and second letter is also a number, that's why it is giving you a false over here. It is strictly matching here. But in this case you can see, if you have first letter is a character and second letter is a number, then it is giving you a true value. It is not strictly matching, it is just searching whether my individual elements contains this pattern or not. If it contains this pattern, then it will give you a true value. It's just checking, it's just searching whether my individual elements contains this pattern or not. If inside that element anywhere this pattern is present, then it will give you a true value. So if I'm putting like this, after 2 I'm putting G, then it will give me a true value here. So here you can see, inside my element if anywhere this pattern is present, then it will give you a true value. So contents method is not strictly checking this pattern, it is just loosely checking. That means if anywhere in my elements this pattern is present, then it will give you a true value. But match method is strictly checking. I should have the initial character should be the number, the initial character should be a number, and the second character should be a string type. So it is just strictly checking this pattern. So here till 3a and 3b you will get the true values, but in this case you will get the false value because this pattern is not matching here. The first character is a number and the second character should be a character type, but here you have integer type, that's why you are getting a false value here. If you remove this integer type, then you will get a true value here. So you can see I have got the true value here. So the difference between the match and contents is, match method matches the pattern strictly while contents method not. So here I hope you have understand what is the difference between match and contents method. So let's see how we can perform some joining operations. Suppose I have a series like this, and inside the series I have a list of elements, and you want to join all these elements and form a single column names. If I have a list like this and you want to join all these elements and you want to form a single column name, then you can use the join method over here. So you can call the join method like this, join of some value you can pass upon which it will be joined. So lion, elephant and zebra have joined with this hyphen values. It will join only the string values. If you have numbers values, then it will not able to join, and it will give you output as an NaN. So in this way you can do the joining operations. So friends, these are some basic operations that we can perform upon my string values. I hope this concept is clear. If you guys have any doubt regarding this, you can leave a comment under my video. Thank you.